Oi.
Wow, when I did my top 10 Highlander Villains video a while back, I had no idea there were so many Jacob Kell humpers out there. Endgame is the only watchable Highlander movie sequel in my opinion, but personally, I think that's more in spite of Jacob Kell than because of him. But apparently the Kell Nation is furious he wasn't included in the original list. Perhaps I should explain the reasons why. So, sorry Kell Sniffers, but this is Crazy Weasel Entertainment's Top 10 Reasons Jacob Kell Sucks! Number 10. His name begins with a K. The infamous Curse of the Ks. Why are there so many damn Highlander villains whose name begin with a K? Kurgan, Katana, Kane, Kallus, Kronos, Canwolf, Kyler, Kristen, to name but a few. Someone at Davis Panzer Productions has an unhealthy, borderline sexualized obsession with the letter K. So before I even say anything about the character himself at all, that's already a black mark on his record. Number 9. No backstory other than his first death. He was raised by a priest, Connor kills him, the end. Then suddenly, he's so powerful he could make Kurgan his butt plug. Who is his teacher? How did he get so strong? Has he seriously done nothing but obsess about Connor McLeod for the last 400 years? Did he learn some kind of mind control or brainwashing to get all these other immortals to follow him around like trained puppies? We're missing some serious details here. Although, to be fair, the same could be said about Kurgan. We didn't get much, if any, of his backstory till the comics. Number 8. Dad jokes.
I call this decaf with a twist. Not sugar.
Enough said. Number 7. Misplaced motivation. Kell's whole vengeful obsession with Connor McLeod comes from Connor having killed his adopted father. Yo, Jake, your saintly dad was gonna kill Connor's mom. What the blessed fuck did you expect, you tit? Number 6. He's not very bright. Yes, Jacob, please drag your sword across that railing, thereby dulling it during a fight to the fucking death. I guess a cool, villainous-looking spark effect is worth losing your head over. Fuck, Michael. Number 5. His wardrobe. I seriously don't get it. Who the balls dresses like this? And where do you even get clothes like that? And the crosses on the shoes thing just makes my butt bleed. What's the significance other than he used to be a priest? Wouldn't that be considered kind of a desecration of the cross? Number 4. He's fucking creepy. And I don't mean in a scary villain way. I mean in like a did-I-say-puppy-I-meant-bike-get-in-the-van kind of way.
What's wrong? Don't you want to be inside me?
Bad touch, bad touch! Number 3. Oh god, the overacting.
Even now you're afraid. Afraid you'll lose. That's your true fear, isn't it? The thought of giving up your essence to me, making me even stronger by it.
Seriously, tone it the fuck down. It looks like he took a correspondence course in Villain 101. It's just not believable, and it comes off so forced. Look at me. I'm a villain. Look how intense I am. Number 2. He breaks the rules. Aside from the whole ganging up thing, there are reasons even guys like Kurgan wouldn't break the rules, especially killing on holy ground, which Kell commits multiple counts of. They explain that killing on holy ground makes bad shit happen. So basically, this many kills on holy ground should have pretty much brought about the apocalypse. But nothing. Not so much as a tremor. And the number one reason Jacob Kell sucks? He was the blue-lipped guy in Dungeons & Dragons. Okay, I know that has nothing to do with Kell as a character, but I'm sorry. Every time I see Bruce Payne, this is what I think of. It's a stigma he's never quite lived down. I mean, Bruce Payne could win an Oscar, cure cancer, and raise the fucking dead, and someone will still say, yeah, but wasn't he that guy with the blue lips in Dungeons & Dragons? And that is Crazed Weasel Entertainment's Top 10 Reasons Jacob Kell Sucks.